With a 10th generation Core i7 CPU and an NVIDIA RTX 2060, this device has an extensive amount of processing power. While it's great for gaming, it's just as good for productivity. With its 15.2-volt lithium-ion battery, the Omen 15 can last an average of about 4 hours when not charging. The Omen 15 gaming laptop also has a very sleek design, accompanied by a fully customizable RGB LED keyboard and a 300Hz monitor.
Buy yours today at store.hp.com.
Each person in the U.S. wastes more than 3,000 gallons of water a year. 6.5 million gallons are wasted in a day because of leaky faucets, water fountains, and hoses. Due to our drought in California, water is being used quickly. So please do your part, fix your leaks, and save water. Thank you.
Good morning, Chieftains. Welcome back to another Live from the Tribe. Thanks for tuning in.
She's Melanie Wilson, and I'm Kara Wicks, and we have the weekly school news for the week of May 16th to the 21st.
Silly goose. Did you say the 21st? That's a Saturday.
Yep, Saturday too. Some seniors are clearing absences and tardies, so Saturday is included.
It's currently in an extreme drought. Lucky for us, San Diego is only in a moderate drought, but in order to stay that way, or totally recover, we must act now. If you want to help reduce your water waste, here are some things you can do. Thrift your clothes, as it takes over 2,000 liters of water to make an average shirt. Make sure to turn off the tap while washing your face or brushing your teeth. Get a rain barrel and save rainwater instead of using a hose. Those are just some things you can do. We encourage you to research what else you could do to help so that we can stop this drought and be on a way to a better Earth.
Seniors are finishing them up right now, and the juniors are already signed up. It's Mesa classes, and this is how they can help you.
As the school year is coming to an end, seniors are preparing for their first year in college, and underclassmen are deciding what classes to take next year. It is never too early to start preparing for college, and here at Clairemont High, students have the opportunity to take Mesa College classes while still in high school.
In the future, I'm hoping to go to Brown University, so I'm taking Mesa College classes in order to improve my transcript, and so that it looks great.
Students can earn college credits by taking these classes and get a taste of what college is really like.
Taking Mesa classes while in high school has prepared me to be in Mesa this fall. So I'm going to Mesa mostly because it's cheap and it's super close to home. And they have the program that I want to do, which is paralegal studies.
I'm excited to take Mesa classes next year because they're going to improve my credentials as well as look really good on my resume. And hopefully that'll increase my chances of going to a better college next year or the years following.
I'm taking Mesa classes next year, and I'm excited because I hope this will prepare me for college and getting a higher education.
Tanika Han, CSN.
We interviewed Dr. Lamont Jackson, the new superintendent of San Diego Unified District. If you didn't know, he was a former Chieftain student and wanted to get to know his student life.
Superintendent Dr. Lamont Jackson visited our school last week, and we had the honor to ask him questions about campus life when he was a student here at Clairemont.
What is different now at Clairemont than when you attended Clairemont?
Well, a few things. One is the modernization of the campus. The arts, the new library is different, the athletic fields, the academies. When I was here, we were on a 4x4 schedule, pretty, you know, fundamental courses, and that's something that is certainly different.
Did your generation have anything to fear, and did you have any personal fears?
I think every generation has its fears, whether it's drug and alcohol. You all are facing challenges with, you know, how successful you will be. We had the same challenge. During the 80s, there was a presence of gangs, and so we had to experience that. And just making sure that we were doing the right thing. I wouldn't say that it's better or it's worse. It's just different. You know, we care about our young people as the adults cared about me when I was a young person. I think there are constant worries about, you know, leaving home, being able to make it on our own, financial stability, work stability, academic stability. So I think those are worries we all experience together. Certainly there's always conversations around drugs, and so that was present as well. So I think there's a commonality there.
How does your experiences at Clairemont reflect on the direction you want to take the district?
First and foremost, I think it was about teachers caring for students. And my experience at Clairemont was, this was home, this was family. And I think it was the camaraderie of the class of 88, the teachers and how much they cared about us. I think about programs like the AVID program, where we were encouraged to take more rigorous coursework. And so this is about equity, and it's about inclusion, and it's about support. That's the direction we want to go as a district. There was a model here for that. And it is certainly rooted in my experience at Clairemont High School that I have a vision with the board and with staff that all of our students can compete for the college and career of their choice. And we should provide that space and let students choose what path they want to go down. Our job is not to determine their future, but to make sure they're prepared for the future.
Getting to know Dr. Lamont Jackson and him being a former chieftain has been an honor to learn from him. We wish him nothing but the best for his ongoing career. Melanie Wilson, CSN.
Get ready for Club Rush on May 19th in the quad during lunch. You don't have to bring your lunch. It's your chance to buy lunch at school. Many clubs will be selling food and treats. There will be chips, drinks, snacks, and more. Last Club Rush, Metro had rolled tacos. Another club had In-N-Out, so you know there will be good food. You can buy tickets for 50 cents from ASB to purchase your food. While you're waiting in line, don't shove, push, or cut people who are in front of you. Keep it orange and blue and come and support your friends in the clubs. Get your cash ready and see you there.
Seniors, do you want to run for prom queen or king? Court nominations are now open. The ballot closes on May 20th and voting is at prom. If you are interested, more information is on the CHS Instagram at CHS Tribe Vibe. Good luck to everyone in the running.
Anime Club has been working on a giant drawing mural for all sorts of anime drawings. Let's see what they have been recently working on.
Hi, my name is Cash. I'm part of the Anime Club in room 107. We're starting a kind of mural-like thing on our whiteboard in our room. It's been going on for maybe a couple weeks. It would be cool if more people came in, watch some anime, have some snacks and stuff. You can always suggest your favorite animes or whatever. Talk with people who enjoy the same things. Yeah, it's a pretty great room. You should come down. It happens every Wednesday.
If you have an interesting story that you want the broadcast crew to announce, you can visit Sparks in the AOB Media Room, and we will love to have it broadcasted on our next show.
We have Audi all day in the Sports Center. Addie, what do you have for us this week?
The girls' softball team has been killing it recently this season, and they're now able to put the year 2022 on their banner in the gym.
This year has been really great with the girls. We've been playing with each other since we were like 8, so it was a great season. And then to win all of our games was a great way to end our senior year.
We are back-to-back league champions, and we are 8-0 in league. It's, I believe, the first time ever that we have swept the whole league, and very proud to be part of this program. Coach Lori and Coach Tom, myself, we couldn't ask for a better group of young ladies.
Sports have ended, meaning preseason football conditioning has begun. Bring the Chieftain Pride to the field after school, plus all summer long. Get cleared through Alfie if you haven't on the Clairemont Athletic website, found in the More tab. Contact Coach Rose at CoachDRose@gmail.com. To wrap up this spring season, the girls softball team won their last league game, which they wrap with an 8-0 league record. And the baseball team won their last league game as well. Congratulations. The girls softball team now moves up to the playoffs. The season has now ended, which means if any of you Chieftains are interested in any fall sports, you'll need to be cleared before trying out. Trials will be determined at a later time. You can go ask Alfie in room 207 and grab the needed paperwork to be cleared. That's a wrap for the sports this week. See you guys soon for the upcoming season. Catch you later. Back to you ladies at the desk.
On this day in history, May 16, 1985, three scientists from the British Antarctic Survey announced their detection of abnormally low levels of ozone over the South Pole. Their discovery, commonly known as the ozone hole, became an acceptable example of mankind's ability to damage the Earth's atmosphere, as well as one of the most famous success stories in the history of climate activism.
That's it for this week's show.
Like the video down below.
And to make sure you don't miss an upload, subscribe while you are at it.
Keep it orange and blue, Chieftains.
Bye!